Thank you very much, Minister. That concludes the debate on tackling social isolation and loneliness. It's now time to move on to the next item of business. And the next item of business is consideration of motion 8720 in the name of Martin Whitfield on behalf of the Standards, Procedures and Public Appointments Committee on Standing Order Rule Changes. And I call on Martin Whitfield to speak to and move the amendment. Move the motion.
I'm very grateful, Deputy Presiding Officer, and it is a pleasure to move this motion in my name, but which is, of course, on behalf of the Standards, Procedures and Public Appointments Committee. And can I thank Bob Dorris, who seconded the motion as Deputy Convener. This motion deals with something that this Parliament has never had to deal with in its past. Of course, we have changed standing orders, but these changes relate to the death of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, and indeed the forthcoming coronation of King Charles III. There are some minor changes required to our standing orders, principally to remove the references to Her Majesty and, of course, replace them with His Majesty. And in that short way, I move the motion in my name.
Very much obliged, Mr. Whitfield. The question on this motion will be put at decision time, to which we now come. And there are four questions as a result of today's business. The first question is that Amendment 8758.1 in the name of Alexander Stewart, which seeks to amend Motion 8758 in the name of Emma Roddick on tackling social isolation and loneliness, be agreed. Are we all agreed? Parliament is not agreed. There will be a vote and there will be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.